I am Ramakrishnan, so I'll be giving some introductory lectures on Hawk and Tilbury Model Forms. And for those who attended the last school, I think some of them you may be knowing that, but anyway, I have to give a short introduction to the subject, and then maybe I'll discuss some problems which I have been working on, so that some new results will be there in my set of lectures. Okay, so I'll start sharing my screen. So now you can see the screen.
Yes, yes,
yes.
Okay, so if any problem, please let me know, so that I can just this one stop and do that. Okay, so as this is preliminary, so as we fix some notation. So for me, this H is the complex approach of plane. And then first we will give a definition of a modular form before I go to the half integral weight. So very brief thing, definition, something in the example, then before we go to the half integral weight. So modular forms, most of you know what are modular forms. A holomorphic function F, defined on the upper half plane having complex values, is called a modular form of, there is a weight and group with respect to this, weight k with respect to the full modular group, or with respect to, just cut this, with respect to the group, I go more generally, gamma 0 n, the congruent subgroup of level n, with character, chi is a Dirichlet character model by n, if already I assumed holomorphic condition, so one is the action with respect to the group action, f of a z plus b, chi c z plus d, a is chi of p, c z plus d, power k, f of z, it should hold for all matrices A, B, C, D belonging to gamma 0 n. So this is nothing but set of all 2 by 2 matrices with left lower entry is divisible by capital N, with the determinant 1, all entries are integers. Second condition is that holomorphic condition of this function in the boundary, therefore cusps. Okay, so F is holomorphic at all the cusps of gamma 0 n. In particular, it has a Fourier expansion at infinity. F of z has a Fourier expansion, which we denote by a f of n e power 2 pi I n is that n is greater than or equal to 0. So this is called the Fourier expansion at infinity. So it has an expansion at each cusp. For each cusp, there should be a Lorentz expansion with no negative term. That is meaning of holomorphic at all the cusps. In particular, at infinity we have this. And if further f vanishes at all the cusps, then we say that f is a cusp form. Vanishing means what? The first Fourier coefficient a f of 0 should be non-zero here. Similarly, at each cusp, there should not be any constant term. So that is the meaning of vanishing at the cusp. Okay, so now examples are standard examples. One is that examples, Isenson series, which all of you know, Isenson series. Ek, where k greater than or equal to, I can say 2 or 4, but for full modular group it is 4, I think I mentioned k greater than or equal to 2. When k equal to 2, there is no Isenson series for the full modular group, but anyway, only for k greater than equal to 2 means it should be considering the subgroup. Okay, so I'll just say for k greater than or equal to 4, define ek of z as follows. You take the normalizing factor cd integers relatively prime, consider this what c z plus d power minus k, and then so whatever the cz plus d is the automorphic factor for the modular form. So I just take the automorphic factor raised to the power minus k, sum over all the series, and where cd are integers. Since cd negative will give you, cd positive, both positive and negative will give you the same one, therefore K should be a leave also, not, note that K is a leave also. You know, when I consider the SL2s. So it is a modular form, so then this belongs to, so forget the notation. Modular form is denoted by MK, N chi. When you look at the weight K, level N, so this level N, the weight K, and then the character chi. The character chi, all of them in this form, M modular form of weight K, level N, and character chi. Similarly, the cusp form is SK, L chi. So if this is the notation, then in that notation, then this belongs to MK of 1. So 1 means the SL2Z, the N equal to 1, chi, there is no character, therefore it belongs to, either you can call it as MK1 or just MK. So without any level or character, then we saw that it is form of level 1, that is with respect to the SL2Z. So it has a Fourier expansion, so EK is a, is 1 minus 2K by DK, Bernoulli numbers, summation K minus 1, you know, Q power N, another change of variable we make, always we talk about the Q expansion. So this e power 2 pi a z is called q, so where q equal to e power 2 pi a z. So in my lectures, whatever I say q, that is not, so e power 2 pi a z, that variable, change of variable, z is in the upper half plane. So it is called the q expansion of e k z, and sigma k n is the sum of the kth powers of the divisors of n, and d k is kth Bernoulli number. Defined by x by e power x minus 1 is summation dk by factorial k x power k. You take this one and the coefficients are called Bernoulli numbers. So this is the classical example. Another example is given by Ramanujan. Ramanujan delta function. Using this Isomson series, one can define this delta. Delta of z is again 1 by 1728 normalizing factor. Is so modular forms, so the space of the set of modular forms form a vector space. So when I multiply two modular forms, they add weight, weights add up. So therefore, if I consider the E4 cube, it is of weight, each one is sorry, E4. Each of weight 4, and then 3 times I'm multiplying, therefore the weight is 12. And then I have E6 also, I also consider. So both of them are modular forms of weight 12, and plus or minus of modular forms, again the same weight. Therefore, it is a modular form of weight 12. But when you look at the Fourier expansion, it starts with 1 and this also starts with 1. So when I subtract it, there is no constant term. Therefore, it is a cusp form by definition. Therefore, it belongs to S12. So it is the first example of a cusp form of weight 12 with respect to the SL2Z. So the Ramanujan considered this function. We consider this Fourier expansion, and then we know that it is Ramanujan. Ramanujan tau function. Tau ones are integers, and there are a lot of things about this one. Next is I will not go much detail because there are many things about tau here. If time permits, I think you know some other lecture, some people will talk about that. So tau, if you are interested, then look at the his paper in 1916. Something is wrong. Why did this one happen? 1916 paper of Ramanujan. One can go through that one, where he talks about this particular tau function and then makes conjectures. There is a history behind that. So now next is that. And because of these conjectures, this KK theory came up. So KK operators. Those who are new, I think I'm just telling. Others, I think they know this very well. So we have the action as is, with respect to the group SL2Z and its subgroups. There is also an action with respect to the GL2 plus Q. The action with respect to GL2 plus Q. So this is set of all 2 by 2 matrices, the rational entries with the determinant non-zero. Okay, so for gamma equal to ABCD belonging to GL2 plus Q, and for functions defined on the upper half plane, define F stroke gamma, so I fix a K of Z is first of all determinant of gamma power minus k by 2 if I am right, or this is no, f stroke is minus k by 2 cz plus d power k. Into f of gamma z. This gamma z is nothing but a z plus b with c z plus d. So therefore, this is the action of gl2 plus q on functions. Okay. So now we will be using this particular stroke operation on functions. So hk operator, nth hk operator. So n is greater than or equal to 1. So take the if f bar Tn of z, I am not going to the details. This is n power k by 2 minus 1 summation av equal to l v modulo of d chi of a f of az plus b by d. That means I am taking the matrix ab 0 d and then acting on f. So when I apply this ab 0 d matrix with the determinant ad equal to n and b mirroring modulo d, and then these are the representatives when you look at the double quotients of representation with respect to the group. Okay, so this, if we simplify further, this will be equal to 1 by n. I am just skipping one step now. Summation ad equal to n chi of a power k summation b modulo d f of a z plus b by b. So now if you plug in the Fourier expansion which we already mentioned, this one Fourier expansion of f at infinity, you substitute here and then sum over b modulo d and simplify, we get the following summation m greater than or equal to 0. That is a Fourier coefficient. Since I am taking the index for the hk operator n, I am choosing m for the Fourier coefficient of the action. So this will be summation d dividing n comma m I of d d power k minus 1 a f of m n by d square q power m. So this is the Fourier expansion of the hk operator on functions. So therefore, so they also satisfy the following relation. This particular relation, if you keep that in mind, the operators also satisfy this condition. When I take the mth operator and nth operator, if I multiply it, so this is nothing but d dividing m comma n chi of d d power k minus 1 t of m n by d square, where m comma n are greater than or equal to 1 integers. Okay, so in particular, if they are relatively prime, so in particular if m comma n equal to 1, we have t m t n is t m n. Therefore they are multiplicative. These operators are multiplicative. Also one can show that they are commutative, therefore, and so Tn forms a commuting family of operators. So next, I think in this space there is an inner product defined on the space. So I don't know, if I spend too much time, then whatever I wanted to tell you will be derailed. So I'll go to the Peterson scalar product, because all these things we have to introduce in the space of half integral weight. Therefore I'm just giving the analogous one which was already existing in the case of integral weight. So for f g in mk n chi, f or g is a cusp form. For the convergence part, we need to assume that one of them is a cusp form. Define the inner product of f and g. It's defined by the Peterson, by Peterson. So this is called the Peterson scalar product. This index of gamma 0 n in gamma and gamma 0 n mod h, integrate over a fundamental domain for gamma 0 n, and then consider this function f of z g of z bar y power k dx dy by y square, where z is written as x plus y. So y is the imaginary part of z, and this is the invariant measure, and this is invariant with respect to the group. Therefore it is a well defined one inner product. So in is index of gamma 0 n in SL2. Okay. So now this TN operators are already defined. They are commutative, and with respect to the scalar product, they are also Hermitian. So TNs are Hermitian. Hermitian with respect to the Peterson scalar product. If n comma capital N is 1. So whenever the n's are, the index n is relatively prime to the level and they are Hermitian operator. In the case of SL2Z, n for every n it is Hermitian, is for commuting family. Therefore, using the linear algebra, one can get a basis for this space of mod cus form, which are eigenfunctions with respect to all H operators. Implies Fk n chi has a basis consisting of Kk eigenform. Kk eigenform means eigenfunctions with respect to all H operators. The all means one has to specify Kk eigenforms for n comma n equal to 1. So not all means not all n. So with the condition that n comma n is 1. So in the case of Sk 1, it has a basis with respect to all eigenfunction with respect to all Hk operators. Okay. So now if f is Hk eigenform, when I say that there is no restriction on the n. Okay, so for all n, if it is Hk eigenfunction, then the Dirichlet series, one can also consider the L function associated to F, Dirichlet series associated to F given by Fs is summation AF of n, n power minus s, n equal to 1 to root. Am I going very fast or is it okay? If I am going very, very fast, then please tell me. Since they are all known, I am going fast. I think when it comes to the main subject, I will go slow. Okay, so even in that case, if I am going fast, please stop me, then I can go little bit slower. Okay, so this is L function you consider associated to a modular form. And then this has an Euler product. Whenever it is an eigenfunction, this L function has an Euler product. L of is product over all p, 1 minus, assume that f of pp is lambda pf. I will come to that, what is lambda p? Pp power minus s plus chi square of p power k minus 1 minus 2s inverse. Here lambda p is nothing but af of p, if provided af of 1 is 1. If it is a normalized eigenfunction, then the eigenvalues are nothing but the Fourier coefficients. Okay, sorry, I think no chi square, it should be chi of p. Okay, so when p divides, people may think that what is this Euler product. Whenever you have the level capital N, whenever p divides N, that the Euler factor is 1 minus lambda pp power minus s only. When it is p not dividing N, this full factor will be there. Therefore, this Euler product splits into two factors. One is with p dividing N and one p not dividing N in the case of level N. So this is the standard examples and then some preliminaries. So another example, which is a classical example of modular form, which I think it is important in our discussion. Another example is the classical eta function, I think which we need it in our thing. So define eta of z is q power n square n integer. Again, I'm repeating e power 2 pi I z is my q of. So this is e power 2 pi I n square z. So consider this series. This defines a holomorphic function. And we'll see that at some point that will be a modular form, but not with the integral weight. And that's why the half integral weight theory started. There is another example, Dedekind eta function. Eta of z defined by eta of z is q power 1 by 24. It's defined as a product, 1 minus q power n equal to 1 to infinity. So And both are modular forms, but they are not of integral weight. Both of are having weight half. So both are holomorphic functions on H. However, they are, I'll put modular form of weight 1/2. So this is, so with the half integral weight theory was, people were trying to generalize the half integral weight theory, but they could not succeed this. But it was Shimura in 1973 who started developing the theory of modular forms of half integral weight in a systematic manner. For him, the transformation for theta is essential. So, Shimura, 1973. So, remarkable paper. So in this paper, using the transformation of theta Z, Shimura developed the theory of modular form of half integral weight. Not only that, he also studied the analog of KK operator, whatever I mentioned, that's what I mentioned, these things in the integral weight case. So we have the analogous definition of a half integral weight modular form, and together with some operator as standard operator which arising from the theory. So one has similar features of scalar product, one can define KK operators. In this case, the KK operators are, they behave in a different way, but not for all integers they will have HK operator. So when you consider only the integers, square free integers, the HK operators become zero operator. So it is not useful. Therefore, one has to consider the HK operators indexed by square. So therefore, that is another important aspect. And moreover, he also in this paper, and then he considered a Dirichlet series associated to a modular form of half integral weight. But unlike the usual one, because one, if I want to use, so when I want to do the Euler product, the essential thing is that the HK eigenfunction and then its Fourier expansion. Use the multiplicative nature of the Fourier coefficients and consider and split this AFN into different factors, and then you can get the Euler factor. In the case of half integral weight, but not for all n, the HK operators are there, therefore it is indexed by p square. Therefore, this kind of Dirichlet series, if you consider, getting an Euler product is not, it is not possible. You won't get the usual modular Dirichlet series. If you consider, you will not get any Euler products in the case of half integral weight. Therefore, Shimura studied a special Dirichlet series, and then using the KK operators, eigenfunction with respect to operators, using the Fourier expansion and using the property of the KK operators on the Fourier coefficient, he showed that certain Dirichlet series has some Euler product expansion. And through that relation, he could give a correspondence between modular forms of half integral weight and modular forms of integral weight, which we will describe in due course of time. So, and then after that, the theory developed, and then Conan introduced a certain subspace. So then Shimura is there. Shimura's work is about mainly correspondence between half integral weight and integral weight, the KK theory, and then this into mainly theta series it is defined. After that, Conan considered a subspace which comes naturally due to the work of Cohen, that also we will describe. So after that, one can give also a correspondence from the reverse direction that was given by Chintani. So who give a mapping from the integral weight modular forms to half integral weight modular forms. Therefore, one can consider this correspondence between half integral weight and integral weight and vice versa. And therefore, after that, Wasserman just made another remarkable relation between the Fourier coefficients of half integral modular forms and the L functions associated to the corresponding integral weight form. So these things will be seeing one by one in this course. So before we start, I think since we are considering the half integral weight, we need to consider the square root of a complex number. So for forms of half integral weight, we need to fix the square root. So fixing square root of a complex number. Okay, that is first thing. So we take the V fix the branch of the square root. Push having its argument in minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. I just take omit the minus pi by 2, include the pi by 2. Therefore, this implies the square root of z is a holomorphic function. On you consider the whole complex plane and remove the negative real axis. Okay, and then if you look at this, I have this. I remove this, including zero, and then I have. Okay, so you also have this. Okay, the whole upper half plane is mapped to the first quadrant. This is z going to root of z. So the whole of upper half plane goes to this. The whole of lower half plane goes to the fourth quadrant, first quadrant and fourth quadrant. This is the square root fixing of square root. So it takes r plus to r plus upper half plane to first quadrant, lower half plane to fourth quadrant. So this is the square root. So that once you fix the square root of a complex number, then for any k in integer z power k by 2 is nothing but you take the square root and raise to the power k. So that is a convention. So therefore, another thing is that we may in the initial days, I think people wanted to generalize the half integral weight by just considering this automorphic factor. So by just replacing k by half integral by using this one, whether one can define a modular form using this one. So this is the automorphic factor. Can one define, have a function satisfying this property for half integral weight? So it won't have a faithful action on the function that can be seen. Therefore, so note that cz plus d power k by 2 or half cannot be an automorphic factor. The reason being, if I have two matrices gamma 1, gamma 2 belonging to SL to Z, which I put gamma 1, then if I take this one, then if I have F bar gamma 1 bar gamma 2 in the same automorphic factor of that function, this need not be equal to F bar gamma 1 gamma 2. So gamma 1 product also has in the belongs to the SL to Z. So I define this action with respect to the stroke, and I define this action separately for gamma 1 applied to gamma 2. Both need will not be equal. Okay, then in some cases, not in all. Therefore, one cannot generalize this kind of automorphic factor in the case of half integral weight. Therefore, this fails to be an automorphic factor in the case of half integral weight. Therefore, one needs to replace this by a suitable factor which satisfies this particular action. So for that, we need to use. So the idea is to use the transformation of the theta function. So if time, then if I have time. So we'll take this before I go to the transformation property. So for a matrix gamma equal to A, B, C, D in gamma 0, 4, I cannot be working on gamma SL to Z. Therefore, I need a starting point for a subgroup, so gamma 0, 4, and then consider this simple C by D, generalized quadratic residue symbol. This is the extension of the Jacobi symbol. So we know the C by D Jacobi symbol, but we have to extend with some kind of convention. So if D is negative, then C by D is defined to be C by mod D if C is positive. Otherwise, you put a minus C by mod D if C is negative. So one extra minus factor, negative factor comes whenever both are negative. Otherwise, if only one of them is negative, that numerator is negative, positive, sorry, if numerator is positive, you don't have problem. It is nothing but C by mod D, then we know what is the definition. So also, the convention is that 0 by plus minus 1, we call it as 1. So whenever it is there. So with this notation, C by D is the automorphic factor, sorry, generalized quadratic residue symbol. Also, another thing is that this epsilon D is nothing but this minus 4 by D, the symbol minus 4 by dot. This has a character model, odd character model of 4. So whenever D is 1 mod 4, it is 1. Minus 1 mod 4, it is minus 1. So then raised to the power half. Therefore, it is 1 or I according as D congruent to 1 mod 4 or D congruent to 3 mod. So that I call, that means epsilon D square is plus minus 1. So that is minus 4 by D. So then we have the following transformation. Property of the theta function. So for a proof, one can see the work of Heke. So consider this theta, A z plus B by C z plus D is, we have the C by D, this quadratic residue symbol, and I have this epsilon D inverse, then C z plus D power half theta of z. So he showed that this theta function satisfies this particular transformation for all matrices A, B, C, D in gamma 0, 4. So therefore, Shimura used this particular transformation and then you took this particular along with this fourth root of unity, along with this Cz plus D power half is not enough. So we have to attach some fourth root of unity to that. So considering this whole as the automorphic factor, then he showed that it is a faithful action on function, therefore one can take this as an automorphic factor. So this factor we denote it by small j of gamma is. Whenever gamma is element in gamma 0, 4, we take the C by D epsilon D inverse Cz plus D power half as the j of small j of gamma is. So this also can be written as theta of gamma is j of gamma is theta of z. So this one can also rewrite this in terms of this. Okay, so using this transformation, we make the following definition. So you just take this as the transformation with respect to the gamma 0, 4 element. So then one can, then whatever the problem happened, this will be overcome. So this is valid. Therefore, this particular transformation, the automorphic factor, therefore, one can define modular forms. Because already an example exists. Okay, theta is an example exists. So one can make a definition. So we use formal definition of a modular form of half a derivative, a holomorphic function defined on the upper half plane is called a modular form of weight k plus half. I'm just sticking to, one can give a unified definition when taking k by 2, I can write, but I specifically mentioned that k plus half as half integral weight, where k is an integer greater than or equal to 1 of weight k plus half with respect to the group gamma 0 n. Since I am going to use the transformation for gamma 0 4, whatever group I am taking should be a subgroup of gamma 0 4, where 4 divides n with character. If a f of gamma is that is chi of d j of gamma is that power 2k plus 1 f of z for all gamma equal to a b c d belonging to gamma 0 n. So now this gamma 0 4 n, that n is divisible by 4, that condition is there. B, as usual, F is holomorphic at all cusps of gamma 0 n. In particular, it has a Fourier expansion. So if F, I am not repeating that, they are similar to integral weight, the F also has a Fourier expansion given by summation AFn q power n, n non-negative. So if F vanishes at all cusps, then we say that F is a cusp form. So we denote this, the model, vector space of modular forms of weight k plus half with respect to the group gamma 0 n with character chi. Similarly, this vector space of cusp forms by m k plus half n chi. I can make gamma 0 n to reduce my writing, so I am putting n chi. So it should be again gamma 0 n chi, because even if you read research papers of Conan, Conan also considers n, and therefore a lot of confusion will be there whether it is a gamma 0 4 n or n. This kind of confusion will be there, but for simplicity I am making this n comma chi, where gamma 0 n replaced by n. Similarly, S k plus half n chi. So this is vector space of modular forms. The same kind of notation I am adopting for integral as well as half integral. Okay. So similar to this particular, I introduced the, for defining the Hecke operators, we needed action of GL2 plus Q on functions. Similar to that, we also need the GL2 plus Q action for forms with respect to the weight k plus half. So that we will see. In order to have a faithful action GL2 plus Q matrices, so we should be considering a bigger group. So therefore, in the case of, already we have seen the, for any matrix ABCD, we take the automorphic factor CZ plus D power half along with some fourth root of unity. Similar to that, we need to have, for matrices belonging to GL2 plus Q also, we need to consider another parameter in the group. So not only the group, together with some holomorphic function also attached to power each group element. So define the bigger group G to be set of all alpha phi of Z. So not only matrix, I am considering another two tuple, the one corresponding holomorphic function. So where alpha belongs to GL2 plus Q, where alpha equal to the lower entry C comma D. So phi is holomorphic on H, such that if I square it, I get C into CZ plus D. So phi is essentially CZ plus D power half along with some root of unity. So fourth, and then not only the determinant of alpha power half. So this whole three will be there, where T belongs to plus minus one, which is capital T is called the fourth root of unity. So T I denoted by plus minus one plus minus five. So the whole thing, that is my bigger group. So not only the matrix along with this extra factors. So for each alpha in GL2 plus Q, and for each fixed T, which is plus minus one, there are two possible candidates in G. I have alpha plus minus phi of Z in G. So therefore G is a group. Note that G is a group with respect to the following operation. So what is the group operation? So take alpha phi of z, another matrix beta and the psi of z. So there are two group elements. One is alpha beta matrices in 0 to plus q. One phi is associated to alpha, psi is associated to beta. This is given by the matrix alpha beta is as usual phi of beta is z into psi of. So the corresponding holomorphic function will be that I have already phi, I apply z to beta z, p of beta z into psi of z. So one can check that this defines the group with respect to the following multiplication. So I have, one can consider the projection map. We have the following projection. Projects from G to GL to plus Q. So if I take the alpha phi is that, naturally the projection is that going to alpha, the matrix alpha. So what is the kernel of this function, projection? Kernel of P is nothing but first of all identity with the phi of z, where p square z is equal to t is plus minus 1. Okay, so that means p is the fourth root of unity. Because p square is plus minus 1, therefore p is fourth. Therefore, the kernel p contains four elements corresponding to the identity. So we have a map. So I can take the root, fourth root of unity to G, where I take the T going to identity comma T. So then once I have this one, so we have this exact sequence. So then we have the following exact sequence. So I have a T to G and G to GL to plus Q. So this is the projection. And then kernel P is the image of T. So kernel of P, image of T. So now consider, so I have the SL to Z. So this is the mapping. I have the SL to Z sitting inside this GL to plus Q. I consider the pullback of SL to Z. I call it as G prime. So let G prime P inverse of SL to Z. Consider the projection, take the inverse. This is set of all alpha phi of Z in G such that alpha in SL to Z. So G dash is a clear subgroup. So G dash is a subgroup of G. And the working rule is that for us is that for subgroups of gamma 04, we take phi of z to be j of gamma z. You see that phi is a holomorphic function. Where is the definition here? Yeah, phi square is t times z plus d. This phi square, the t is given by the c by d into epsilon d inverse. That one I take it as the fourth root of unity for this phi whenever this gamma belongs to gamma 04. For all other groups, we take the pullback P inverse 1 under the projection map. Because when you consider modular forms, you need to introduce a lot of operators. So when you want to do some operators which matrices belong to GL to plus Q, we have to fix the automorphic factor for that. So that one I define using the pullback of this projection map. But whenever the element belongs to the gamma 04 group, then I have to take only J gamma z. Under this rule, we work. Okay. Therefore, for
hello, sir.
Yes.
Can you please repeat this working rule, sir?
No, working rule means what? I see there is a projection map is there. Okay. projection is from bigger group to the, I projected this one. Therefore, pullback means what? Pullback means I have four choices for each matrix.
Okay.
So anything you can take. So that's what I'm saying. There is no fixing in that one. So according to, so once you fix something, you have to check whether the, when you want to do operation there, stroke operation, you have to see whether it is faithful operation. Accordingly, you can select. There is no fixing there. You can fix anything. Okay, but when it is gamma 04, you cannot have any choice other than J gamma. That is the meaning.
Okay.
Is it clear?
Okay. Yes.
So when I do some this one operators, then you will see that why I have taken that. One can take different output. The point is that extra constant will flow up in your calculation, but accordingly you have to do that. Okay. So okay. This things you will understand when I introduce the operators in the space. So later on you will see that. So for psi equal to alpha c of z belonging to G, we denote the action of G on H by, so this whenever action of the group means I take only the matrix action. Only for the stroke operation this phi plays a role. That is, this is the difference between my integral weight and half integral weight. The group is exactly the same, whatever group you are acting, that will be there on the action of the upper half plane. Weight complex variable it is same. But when it comes to the stroke, then I have to play along with this another factor phi of z. The action of gz on H is given by psi z is nothing but alpha z. So I am not changing anything that action with respect to the matrix. Then for f functions depend on upper half plane, we define f stroke k plus half psi of z defined to be, I have the function phi z, which your choice, one of the four elements you can take, raise it to the power 2k minus 2k minus 1, and then f of alpha z. It should be in psi z, but psi z is exactly alpha z. Okay, now with this, one can verify easily. That for psi 1, psi 2 in G, f bar k plus half, psi 1 bar k plus half, psi 2 is f bar k plus half, psi 1, psi 2. So one can have means what? I think you have to, there may be some, see when you do psi 1 and psi 2 independently, okay, so you have a choice of the phi z corresponding to psi 1 and psi 2. But I can also consider psi 1, psi 2 product. There is also automatic factor is already defined, that phi is already defined because that is the group action. That is that one, yeah. When I have alpha, beta, this is psi 1 and psi 2. This exactly this is defined as psi 1, psi 2 has this particular function in the corresponding holomorphic function. So when I consider psi phi corresponding to psi 1, psi corresponding to psi 2, then phi of beta is that psi of z is nothing but the function corresponding to psi 1, psi 2. That's the one, that's what I am saying. So this will be, according to that group law, this will be satisfied. Okay, this is all very basic thing about half integral weight, how we act on that. Now we go to some remarks we have to see. There is some special properties which we have to observe in the case of half integral weight. So when you consider modular forms of integral weight, so there is a, so recall, I'm k, there won't be any confusion with me because when I consider k by 2, then I have to say whether k is an integer or even integer or something like that. So k by 2 integer or not. Now since I'm considering k as integer, when I say mk, it is an integral weight form. When I say mk plus half, it is a half integral weight. So we call when k is greater than or equal to 1, consider this mk n chi. So this is the modular forms of weight k, level n chi is 0 unless chi of minus 1 is minus 1 power k. So therefore, whenever k is an odd integer, the chi should be an odd character. Whenever k is an even integer, chi should be an even character. Therefore, there is a parity between chi and k in order that the space contains non-zero forms. Okay, this condition is there. But on the other hand, when you consider the half integral weight case, we cannot have chi odd character. Whatever k plus half you will take any integer, this character should be even. So that's what we will observe first. So if chi is an odd character, then the space m k plus half n chi is zero. So now I assume that 4 divides n in this case because half integral way. So minus identity belongs to gamma 0 n. And then what is j of minus identity is that? So now since it is a gamma 0 n element, I have to talk about the automorphic vector, the j. This is nothing but, so that is minus identity is 0, minus 1, 0, 0, minus 1. C is 0, D is minus 1, therefore it is 0 by minus 1, epsilon minus 1 power half, am I right, or minus half or plus half? I should can check here, it is going up. J gamma is that is, yeah, minus half, epsilon D power minus half, epsilon minus 1 power minus half, and C is plus D is minus 1 power half, okay, into this is Cz plus D power half, that's all. Sorry. So now compute the 0 by plus minus 1 convention is 1. Epsilon minus 1 is I power minus 1, this is I. Therefore, this cancels out, therefore I have 1. Okay? So when you look at this automorphic factor for corresponding minus identity, I have J minus Z is 1. Therefore, when I take a function here, if I apply F bar minus I J of minus I Z, it should be equal to what? According to my definition, it should be chi of minus 1 into the stroke operator I put. This is the definition of otherwise into f of z. When I do that, action is f of z. The left hand side is nothing but j gamma z power. This is left hand side is nothing but f of z. You see? Left hand side also is equal to this one, chi of minus 1, f of z. So whenever chi is an odd character, this implies f is identical to 0 if chi is odd. So therefore, when you consider the modular forms of half integral weight, always take chi character to be an even character. So therefore, if when you consider this space with respect to the gamma 1, so recall again, mk n chi is nothing but, if I take the direct sum of all chi Dirichlet character modulo n, mk of it should be, I think I'll cut it, mk gamma 1 n is nothing but the direct sum of all characters mk n chi. So you take the spaces with respect to all Dirichlet characters, you take the direct sum, therefore given any function here, I can always find a contribution there. All these functions belong to mk gamma 1 n. So given any function which is modular with respect to gamma 1 n, the character will be fixed with respect to the d element. Therefore, in the case of half integral weight, since whenever chi is an odd character, this part is 0, we have k plus half gamma 1 n. So I have to consider 4 dividing n in this case, is direct sum chi even character modulo n, m k plus half n chi. So that is the main difference here. Okay. Now we come to the examples. Okay, what is the time? I'm going slow, I think. Okay, examples. Already we saw one example. Theta series is, that's what we started with, q power n square minus infinity to plus infinity. It is a modular form of weight half of level 4. So that is a basic, no? For us, theta is a basic function which satisfies this transformation property. Yeah. Theta of gamma z is j gamma z theta z. Therefore, the weight is half here. Therefore, it is a modular form of weight half with respect to gamma 0 4. So that is my theta. And then I can take, so let let k be an odd integer, then theta power k of z is not, belongs to m k by 2. Now k is an odd integer, by 2 means it is half integral, so it is level 4. Level 4 is correct. Remember that. So that is a modular form. I can also generate using odd powers of theta. I consider that is also half integrated modular form, level 4. So when k is even, it is an integral rate modular form. So theta power k belongs to m k by 2 4 if 4 divides k, otherwise m k by 2 4 chi minus 4 if k is 2 modulo 4. So this chi minus 4, this notation I always use. Chi m is m by dot, Kronecker symbol I use. So chi minus 4 is minus 4 by dot, is a odd character modulo 4. So this notation I fixing throughout my lectures. Okay, whenever chi suffix something comes, that is a denominator, it is a character modulo either m or 4m, according as m is 1 or 3 modulo 4. So that you should know the Kronecker symbol. Okay, next is that this eta function I told that this is 1. It's, if you refer to Ono's book, I'm not going both details. It is also a half integral form. I think the level is 576 to 24 square. So if the level will increase, otherwise you cannot bring down the level. It is a very half, but I have to work with a much smaller subgroup. And then another natural example, natural means what? I can consider theta function is there. I can always multiply by a weight k modular form, because when I product two modular forms, the weight adds up. So when I have a weight k modular form and weight half is there, therefore I can have a k plus half. Therefore, if f belongs to mk n chi, then I consider f theta, because this I am going to discuss one of the problems. I think when you talk about the Shimura correspondence, I will come to this particular example of modular form, and we will see some very special and interesting property of the Shimura maps on this type of function. Okay, if I multiply f with the theta, the weight is k, weight is half, this belongs to m k plus half. Level is, because already I have to put 4 here, because n I do not know, I just n1 I put, n1 we will see what it is. The chi is a character, I cannot put character chi here, because we saw already that when chi is an odd character, the space is 0. Therefore, I can have a chi odd character in this case whenever k is odd. That's what we saw in integral weight. When k is odd, chi is an odd character. But still I get a form. So in order to compensate this one, I should multiply by chi minus 4 power 4. Okay, so the product is always an even character here. So when I take k even, this factor will go away, because anyway the level is 4 is there, character will be a modulo 4 character. So when k is odd, I think I have to introduce my chi minus 4, because this is an odd character, this is odd character, it will cancel out. And what is n1? So n1 is nothing but LCM of 4 and n. Because we do not know anything about n. N can be odd also. When n is odd, I have to put 4n. When n is even divisible by 2, I put 4n only. Okay, if n is 2 times capital M, the level will be 4 times capital M. So I have to take the LCM of 4 and m. So this another interesting example. And also in Shimura's paper, he defines a theta series with characters. That also we need it. So theta series with characters. So we consider the classical theta series. We just took only the exponential 2 pi a n n square is there. If I introduce for any primitive character, if I introduce the factor psi here, they are all generalized with theta series. It was considered in Shimura's paper, and then because he needed them, so all they refer to Shimura's paper, 1973. Okay, but this reference also should be there. Whenever whatever I say, most of them will be there, or in Koblet's book will be there, or Ivanich's book, one of the things will be there. So you can just, there are standard references which I use. So let psi be an even character modulo or. So take an even primitive, sorry, even primitive Dirichlet character. Primitive Dirichlet character modulo small r. Now consider, so set, I have the theta corresponding to this psi defined to be, I have n integer, I have e power 2 pi I, n square is it, and then I put the psi n here. So whatever I just twist with the character psi, this is called generalized theta series. So when r equal to 1, that means conductor 1 means primitive modulo 1 is psi, there is no character there. So this theta psi is nothing but is a classical theta function. Okay, so when r is not equal to 1, that means the character is a non-trivial even primitive Dirichlet character modulo r, then theta psi is 2 times summation n equal to 1 to infinity psi of n e power 2 pi I n square z, and this is nothing but 2 times q plus psi of 2 q power 4 plus psi of 3 q power 9, it goes on like. So I think in Shivara's paper, he, because of this property, he adds one half factor there so that to get rid of this 2. So then he shows that this theta psi belongs to m half, because I have taken an even character, the weight will be half only, into 4 times r square, because the level is already 4 and I started with r, so 4 r square and then character is psi. Remember, the psi is an even character. So more generally, one can take any psi, can be even, not necessarily even, psi can be any primitive Dirichlet character. So then the small adjustment has to be done in the definition. If psi is any primitive Dirichlet character modulo R, then define, one can take this, replace this by this following definition so that it unifies this and then the present one, which I am going to say. This is equal to summation minus infinity plus infinity psi of n, n power nu, e power 2 pi I, n square is that, where psi of minus 1 is minus 1 power nu, where nu is 0 or 1 according as chi is even or odd. So when chi is a, psi is an even character, the nu is 0, therefore n power 0 is 1, so this factor was not there, otherwise n will be there. So it is either psi n into e power 2 pi a n square z when psi is an even character, otherwise n into psi n e power 2 pi a n square z when n psi is an odd character. So then put psi 1 as psi into chi minus 4 power nu. So there is minus 4 by dot, that character power nu. Then this theta function belongs to m nu plus half of 4 r square psi 1. So the nu is 0, it is a weight half, already we saw that. So when nu is 0, it matches psi 1 is psi, because nu is even, this will not be there, psi 1 is psi. Otherwise, more generally, it is weight 3 by 2 or weight half. So depending on your choice of the character. So again, in Shibura's paper, the factor of half is there. So one has to introduce 1 by 2. Because of the character, so 0 constant term will not be there. N equal to 0 will not be there. Therefore, one can put the half. Otherwise, it will be a confusion. Okay. So next is, okay, any questions about that? Because I'll just again go to the next part. Probably I will discuss what are the things which I will be doing. So instead of going to the one, maybe in the afternoon class, I discuss something about the Isenson series, then Peterson scalar product and KK operators a little bit. And then I will see, explain what is the Shimura correspondence. And then maybe in the subsequent lectures, one of the things we will consider is the special property of the Shimura correspondence. So the topics before I go to that, so I introduce this this one, or the, I brief about isosceles series, because proving these things will take a lot of time. So we'll just see what is isosceles series and the Hecke operators, and then see once we these two are there, what is the Shimura map. The moment I know what is the Hecke operators, and then with some properties I can go to the Shimura map. Special property we'll see a little later, that individually we'll see that. And then after Shimura's work, I think the work of Cohen isosceles series, this also will say that when I talk about this one, it will be isosceles series. And then Cohen's work, so using the starting point for Cohen's work is the Cohen isosceles series, then we introduce the subspace, and then whatever the Shimura's work is extended by Cohen, and then there is a Shintani map, brief about that, and then Vasco's theorem, and then again this continued. If time permits, we'll talk about new form theory, and then certain property I mentioned also, that Atkin-Leonard operators. And their properties. Okay, property means I'll again, like the special one, we talk about this. So these are the topics I'm thinking of. Let us see if time permits we can go further. Otherwise, I can go little bit extra on these things. So with the how much 20 more minutes, probably I'll introduce the isosceles series a little bit, and then we'll continue in the afternoon. The speed is okay or slow? I want to slow down, or whoever is feeling that is very fast. The many people are known to me, therefore for them I am not asking. For new people I am asking. There are many people who who have attended my courses there, and also attended one of the courses given in KSOM. For newcomers, if you feel that I am going fast, I slow down. In any case, you can just stop me. So there is no, don't hesitate stopping me and ask. Okay, so the group gamma 0 4, it has three cusps, has two regular cusps. I'll just discuss about the regular or irregular things. Regular cusps, this happens only in the case of asymptotic waves because of the extra automorphic factor. Two regular cusps, infinity and zero. So corresponding to this, therefore the co-dimension, even if I took the Petersen norm, if a Petersen scalar product, if you take it, the orthogonal complement of cusp form will be the isosceles series. Therefore the co-dimension is only 2. So because the vanishing property will have only 2, so the corresponding, the space of isosceles series is spanned by 2 of them. We call this one is infinity. This is corresponding to infinity, and one is fk plus r corresponding to the cusp 0. We'll just describe these things, definition, and then we'll indicate their Fourier expansion, and then we will see a particular combination gives you another interesting property of the isosceles series. So corresponding to infinity, so not at, I should not say at. So ek plus half is that the definition of isosceles series is that you take the trivial function, that one function, take the Stroke operator with respect to the automorphic factor, and then sum over the matrices modulo gamma infinity. So gamma infinity modulo gamma 0 4, j of gamma z power minus 2k minus 1, where k is greater than or equal to 2. So when you expand, right, gamma as matrices with lower entries as m, m and n, this will become summation 4 divides m, n positive, and the GCD of m comma n is 1. I have the residue symbol m by n, epsilon n power 2k plus 1, and then I have m is f plus n power minus k minus half, because half is there, so even minus k minus half. So this is the Fourier expansion of the Isenson series. So it is convergent. Then, as usual in the case of integral weight, you do the take the representative, you use the Poisson summation formula to expand this one in terms of a Fourier series, but these extra factors are there. This one has to take care. So this belongs to m k plus half 4. Okay. So this is, I'll talk about the Fourier expansion in the, after defining f also. So next is f k plus half. I have already have the Isenson series at the cusp infinity, and then if I apply the W operator, H4 operator, it takes infinity to the cusp 0, then I get another Isenson series. Therefore, I take the Isenson series. This is the normal way of defining the Isenson series at different cusps. So this is the H of the Fricke involution for gamma 0, 4, 0, minus 1, 4, 0. The corresponding automorphic factor is square root of 2. Okay, so that phi is in this case is, if you look at the definition of phi, and then you can just do that. I have taken square root of Cz plus G only, I have taken. That means whatever the p equal to 1 in this case. Okay. That means if I do this stroke is with respect to the weight k plus half, the GL2 plus Q action, you apply this operator on EK plus half, we get another function which we define fk plus half. Okay, this is after expanding in the case of if I apply the definition of the stroke operator which I gave before. There is that one I gave. One has to use this one. Did I define p? No. Yes, this one. Yeah, use this one and expand, and then I get this. Okay, and then we get is 2 power minus k minus half after simplification, m and integers, n positive and odd, and GCD of m and 1, and I have minus m by n, and epsilon n power 2k plus 1, I have the n z plus m power minus k minus half. Okay, this also belongs to m k plus half. We have two Isenson series, e k plus half corresponding to the two regular cusps 0 and infinity, and then we have the following fact, which is theorem, but I am not saying not explicitly, explicit version. Not explicit version. So don't, you can just refer to, even if you look at Kobler's book, it doesn't give full Fourier expansion. It is very difficult to do that. Okay, so writing, only in some cases the Fourier coefficients are explicitly given. Writing E k plus half of Z is summation L equal to 0 to infinity A L q power L. Q is the e power 2 pi A Z, and f k plus half, z is l equal to 0 to l equal to 1 to infinity in this case, b l q power l, then one can show that this a l and b l up to some factors are equal to, this should be the or equal to the L function value L of chi minus 1 power k times L at 1 minus k. So this is the character, is chi minus 1 power kl, that means minus 1 power kl by dot character we have to take is Dirichlet series of this character at the value 1 minus k. So where minus 1 power kl is either 1 or 2 comma 3 modulo. There will be two cases. One case is the minus 1 power kl is 1 mod 4, it is a character modulo l, and the other one is modulo 4 times this number. So, okay, there are two cases, and both of the cases one can show that whenever it is the, it defines the fundamental discriminant, then it's square free number. If l is square free with this property, so it will be a discriminant of a quadratic field. In that case, this Fourier coefficients are equal to up to some factors, these l special values of the l function corresponding to the characters of the quadratic field. Using this, Cohen, what he proved is a linear combination of these two gives exactly the L function. You can just cancel all the factors and he obtained exactly the Fourier coefficient of one function. It's a combination of these two, which gets rid of all the other factors and remains only the L function value whenever it is a fundamental discriminant, that is the discriminant of a quadratic field. So k greater than or equal to 2, ek plus r, fk plus r as above, then define hk plus half of z as the Riemann zeta function zeta of 1 minus 2k into the isosceles series ek plus half plus this factor 1 plus I power 2k plus 1 2 power minus k minus half into this fk plus half. So I have the two constant, one is 1, and the second constant is 1 plus I power 2k plus 1 into 2 power minus k minus half times f. When you do that, it is a modular form. Anyway, since both are modular forms, some combination also is a modular form. Yes, here the modular form of weight k plus half on gamma 0 4, okay, which is called the Cohen-Eisen series. So if it has the following property, for its Fourier coefficient, so if capital D is minus 1 power k L or minus 1 power k 4 L, that means whenever it is L is square free with this property, the corresponding discriminant will be the minus 1 power k L. In this case, it will become 4 times that. Okay, where L is positive. If is the discriminant of a quadratic field, and take the chi d is d by dot character, which is d by dot is the corresponding character, then the mod d Fourier coefficient of hk plus half z is equal to L of chi d 1 minus k. So this is a special value of the Dirichlet character chi d at 1 minus k. So when I write hk plus r, in fact I'll write in advance, one can express hk plus half z equal to summation hk plus half n q power n as a Fourier series n greater than or equal to 0, then hk plus half n is 0 unless minus 1 power k n is congruent to 0 or 1 modulo 4. Okay, that is the property, one can prove this one. In fact, if minus 1 power k n is the discriminant of a quadratic field, this xk plus of n is nothing but this L function y. Whenever it is a fundamental discriminant, it takes the value. Otherwise, only these coefficients survive. So later we will see that this condition determines a subspace of mk plus of n kind. Okay, produced by Conan. That is called the, so what Conan did is that by looking at this particular example for which this kind of property holds, okay, this particular function, which is the linear, particular linear combination of the two vices in series, has the property that its nth Fourier coefficient is zero unless minus 1 power k n is a square modulo 4. So then what he did, he defined this condition for a subspace and showed that there is a natural way one can get a subspace. So he introduced another operator for which this particular subspace becomes an eigenspace. So that is the work of Conan. He called the subspace as a plus space, which is called the Conan plus space. We'll, in later things, we will see that. Already 5 more minutes. I think I'll stop at this point. Any questions you ask, then I will continue in the afternoon and then go to the Shimura maps, etc. Because please ask any questions now, because I don't want to. I can introduce the scalar product same way, and then that much, and then I do. There is nothing new about the Petersen scalar product, the same one. I'll just mention Petersen scalar product. So for FG in MK plus R, N chi, F or G is a cus form defined. The inner product f of g, f and g to be 1 by index integral gamma 0 n f of z, g of z bar, y power k plus half dx dy by y square, where z equal to x plus i. Okay, is as the Petersen scalar product on mk plus of n chi. Okay, so I n is the index of gamma 0 n in H. That's in SL2Z, sorry, not in H. So I use the index. So in the same way, we define the Petersen scalar product, and then the proof is exactly the same along the same lines. Therefore, with respect to this inner product, one can show that the Hecke operators which we introduce become Hermitian. Therefore, this most of the theories will go similar to that. The only difference is that Hecke operators will not exist when n is a square free index. So only for square index, this operator is non-trivial. One has to work with some square indices Hecke operators in the case of Hamiltonian matrix. So in the afternoon, we'll see the Hecke operators a little bit and then see what Shimura correspondence is. Any questions, please?
So I have a question. The space of this Eisenstein series, it is always equal to the number of cusps, is it so?
The codimension is always equal to the number of inequivalent cusps, okay?
Okay.
But in this case, I think because of the, that is because we are putting the restriction of the cusp form definition is vanishing at the cusp, right? But yeah. In the half integral limit case, all the modular form vanishes all the key irregular cusps. That I will explain in one lecture. So therefore, that condition is automatic. Therefore, we cannot get extra isomorphism. Therefore, the codimension in this case is the number of a regular cusp only. Therefore, in this case, there are only two cusps which are regular. Therefore, we have two isomorphisms.
And what are good references for half integral weight? Is it, I mean, Koblitz book is there probably, and
there is a book by some two Chinese, but I think I understand that there are a lot of mistakes in that. So. I think so far, I think Koblitz book is the only reference. Otherwise, there is no.
I mean, expository article kind of.
Expository. I think we can search the net, but there are not complete one is there.
I see.
I don't think any other thing other than Koblish book one can refer.
Okay.